So we feel like we got a good kind of group hug, feeling a little better.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Oh,
Hakeem
boy.
In Alabama, you are on live with
Hello.
Eric and EJ. How are you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing all right. I went back and listened to our conversation a few times since last weekend. EJ, did you happen to
Yes, I definitely listened to it too.
Well, do you have any corrections to make before we jump into things and kind of... Well, let's recap for people who haven't seen last week's episode. In last week's episode, you called up and you were, I believe, talking about chaos. And
Wait a minute. Before I don't mean to cut you off.
No, go ahead. What's up?
Before you continue, just real quick, I want to thank you for the platform that you provide for people to be able to call in and give ideas and thoughts on things. And I think it's very much so needed and very healthy. So I appreciate you and your crew for the work that you do. Appreciate it.
You hear that, crew? Thank you.
No problem.
Hey, Akeem, that's really nice. We appreciate it, and we do want to have the conversations. I know that it sounded heated, but when I hung up the phone last time, I was feeling just fine. Were you feeling all right?
Yeah.
I
was looking forward to calling you again.
Good. For a lot of people, you know, especially when they were talking, they were saying, oh, they were just tearing each other apart. No, you can respect the person. I think you should respect
right. The
human that you're talking to, but that doesn't mean that bad ideas are okay, and it doesn't mean that you should respect bad ideas. You should be able to approach them and talk about them, because if you are intellectually honest about it, if you care about what the truth is, then you should be open to it. And I try to give myself as an example of somebody who thought that he knew what was going on. I believed fully that Jesus Christ had saved me. And
right.
I found out that I was wrong. And it takes that sometimes, and especially for people with a hard head like me who needed to learn it firsthand. But it's okay to be wrong. It's okay to grow and learn, especially when you want to know the truth. So, with that said, I just wanted to get that out there because I do want to have a conversation, but I do want this conversation to be a little more structured. Last time we kind of got off and went on a couple tangents. So let's see if we can kind of focus down, okay?
Okay, sure.
All right. So do you want to sum up the last talk, or do you have something different that you want to talk about today?
I would love to start off on the last talk, but okay. I do want to comment on the discussion that was, I think, the caller before last.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know the other host's name.
I'm EJ.
EJ,
mm-hmm.
You said?
Yes.
Yep, Hakeem, okay. EJ, Hakeem.
Nice to meet you, EJ. she has stated that that you'll determine whether you're a boy or girl by a doctor looking at your genitals and seeing if it looks more like a penis or more like a vagina. And Ben stated that she's not medically, you know, very a professional in the medical field. So my suggestion is don't make that kind of statement if you're not, because
I'm not a professional in the medical field, but I've done plenty of research on this because it is my identity. So I know a fair amount about it. So
yeah, I mean,
but that's not the case. It depends. It's we have 46 chromosomes, and 22 of them, other pairs are called autosomes, and that's in the male and female. But the 23rd pair.
Yes, the XX and XY. I've heard this argument before, and quite frankly, it's boring.
The sex chromosome. That's what differs in the male and female. All the other 22 are the same in male and female.
Okay.
But it's not just X and Y, and I really don't want to get into this.
Yeah, Hakeem, let's go to the next subject.
I'm just saying, but that's the correct science.
But it's not correct, actually.
And Hakeem, you were doing this last week. I am honestly sitting here. I am not a cosmologist. Right, I don't have a degree in philosophy, but here I am doing my best to make this right, you know, and to make sense of this. I'm going to call bullshit on the assertions if you say that is the science.
Yeah, what is your background in biology?
Well, hold on, stop. We do have the person who is going to school to become an engineer, and what kind of engineer exactly?
Aerospace
engineer. So we were talking about the stars.
Right.
So if we're going to talk about to somebody who does have more information, that's the conversation I'd rather have. So let's just
Not to mention that the info that you're talking about, the biological nature of chromosomes and sex chromosomes and whatever, that is available. Right. Like, you can find that information, and just asserting right. that, oh, it's one way or the other, the last time you would have heard that would be ninth grade biology. So maybe go read a research paper and then come back and talk about XX and XY.
And do it when EJ's on, because I have no freaking clue what's going on.
Okay.
That's the
medical science of it.
But are you a medical professional too?
Because you can't try to discredit me because I admitted that I'm not a medical professional when you aren't either.
Yeah. So can we please get to the next argument?
I think that our doctors have it wrong.
Holy crap! Come on.
We trust our doctors, right?
No, we're talking about something else. Do you have anything else you want to talk about?
Yeah. This is boring. Yes. This is overdone. Yes. This information is freely available.
Yes. Yeah, sure. That's not my topic, but
cool.
Okay. We was talking about you mentioned something about chaos. Mm-hmm. I think, Eric.
Mm-hmm.
And I think you said if you wanted to talk about the last, we didn't get a structural something
yes.
established about the discussion. Yeah.
Yes.
So if you can elaborate on Absolutely. What you want me to.
So from what I remember, and please let me know if I'm wrong, but I remember us talking specifically about intelligent design. And you
yes.
had made a couple of assertions, and among those assertions, you said, if it was chaos, then you can look up into the sky and there would be explosions going on all of the time. Was that accurately?
Let me elaborate on that, what I meant
okay.
by that. Okay.
Because, I mean, this cosmos is not like a firework.
I know you all are pretty intelligent on things, so I didn't feel I needed to go, per se, on detail on that aspect, but yes, we have a lot of cosmic energies, all that goes on, exploding stars. Yes, it exists, and it goes on a daily basis. But we don't see the effects because of the distance of these effects. You understand? So by the universe expanding, it's moved. All of these things are moving further away from our solar system, not closing in on us, which would make them not only less dangerous to us, but also less visible and studyable for us. That's the cosmologists of today's date.
That's not how any of that works.
EJ, would you correct? Because this is not, again, not so, my, I feel like I
okay.
just need to kind of hang out and...
Something happened?
Okay, so first of all, the expansion of the universe, I don't think we really should get into that because none of us here is an expert in astrophysics. I think we have somebody in the audience who knows a little more about that, but...
We do have an astrophysicist, that's right.
Yeah, none of us here in this conversation are experts in astrophysics. Now, I know a fair amount about stars and how they work, so I could probably talk a little bit more about that, but I don't want to talk about, like, the expansion of the universe or anything like that, just because we're not experts, and the
right.
conversation that we would have would be based in kind of our assumptions of how that works and not in how the actual physics of it functions.
Right. But see, this is the thing. See, we don't have to be experts to get this information as human beings. We do not have to be experts. The science is available for every human being on this planet to get this information, just like you can get the information.
It's available, but you need to have a baseline of knowledge to be able to understand it.
We don't have to be an expert to identify that the Earth spins. Do we not? Do we or do we not?
Okay. Let's get past the silly stuff.
That was clear. Whether or not we need to be experts, I'm saying, because she made that claim. That we need experts to identify things that exist around us. I don't understand. We do not.
Okay. So what do you want to talk about specifically?
The work has been done by many, many scientists, so I don't understand.
No, I'm just going to call bullshit if you claim that what you're saying
is the
work of a scientist.
If you make assertions without having all of the knowledge about what we're talking about, those assertions are necessarily going to not be reliable.
That didn't carry any weight to it. What assertion did I make that didn't carry any weight to it?
Well, you started talking about the expansion of the universe, and the way that you talked about it made it pretty clear. Can you stop talking over me, please?
Yeah, sure.
So you mentioned the expansion of the universe, and the way that you described it isn't actually how that works, really. You said that it should be harder to observe, and that's not actually the way that it works. It has to do with the actual space-time expanding, and that's why I don't want to get into it, because we're talking about really high-level physics that, you know, I know some about it, and I could talk to you a little bit about it, but I am not going to claim to be an expert, and it would be disingenuous of me to do otherwise. There is power in saying, I don't have all the information right now. Now, if I could have access to research papers and I could pull them up and we could go through this line by line and we could talk about how this functions, I would be happy to do that. I don't have those right now. But if I had that information, we could have that conversation. I just don't want to have one right now where we're making assertions and assuming how things work when we don't actually know for sure that that's how it functions.
Okay, so I use
assertion actually of distance, which is time and distance, one and the same. It's the distance that they are, which is the same as time, distance, you know.
No, Hakeem, that's actually
I'm sorry, that's
wrong.
Not.
So when I now don't get me wrong, time,
yes,
energy, matter, right? Those are all fundamentally related to each other through special relativity. Right. We do know that. But time and distance are separate things. I don't know how you got to that. Does this relate to whether or not a God exists? Because I feel like we are halfway through the show.
Yeah,
we haven't had very much atheism talk.
That's
kind of why I'm here.
That's what you titled it, but I never called for discussion whether or not God exists. I was calling in reference of the design of the universe.
So you don't, you're not talking about whether a God exists or not?
That's what it was, and I had gave
Hakeem,
you a number.
Hold on.
All throughout
hold on.
The universe.
Hakeem, you're not talking about whether or not a God exists?
No, I brought
and
up,
you called an atheist
trial. I had a question for you of how the universe came to exist. That was my very first question.
Yes, talk to a physicist. If you don't, you're not talking about
Y'all said y'all didn't know, and then that's how we got into chaotic, you know.
Got it. Yeah, talk to a professional give us a call if...
I never got a chance to answer that question of the unseen.
Because I really don't care. This is an atheist show. I'm not going to sit here and give you a soapbox for us to talk if we're not even talking about the same thing.
Yeah, why does your lack of knowledge about how the universe functions have anything to do with God?
I'm going to move on. Take care, Hakeem. If you think of something about atheism that you want to talk about, cool.
Yeah, let's
But if you want to argue with somebody, find a professional and don't bother us.